So what's the science we use to study the ancient migratory paths of your ancestors? It's something called population genetics, and it helps us to piece together how humans populated the Earth. Here's how it works. Historically, people close to each other tended to share more of those genetic markers, the little DNA typos passed on from parents to their kids, than they did with people on the other side of the world. It makes sense. After all, who were they more likely to meet, fall in love with, and have babies with? The people living nearby. Over time, this created regional patterns of genetic variation. So the people living in, say, northern Spain had more markers in common with each other than they did with people in Indonesia. These regional patterns of variation allow us to track the migratory paths of your ancestors. By looking at where in the world your markers are found, we can figure out where you came from. And by looking at the order in which these markers have occurred over time, and where in the world they originated, we can actually track the journey your ancestors followed from an African homeland to where you came from more recently. How do we find these markers in the billions of A's, C's, G's, and T's? It's not easy. It's a little like finding needles in a haystack. That's because when a mom and a dad have a baby, their chromosomes are copied and passed on to their child, but not in a straightforward way. Instead, mom and dad's chromosomes are shuffled when they're passed on to their kids. Imagine a deck of cards containing only hearts, and another containing only spades. Now, shuffle them up, and look at your hand. It's going to be a mix of hearts and spades, the cards your parents have, but in a different combination. This makes tracking our markers really hard for most of our chromosomes, but we found a shortcut. There's one of your 23 pairs of chromosomes that gets passed on virtually unshuffled. It's called the Y chromosome. If we look at your Y chromosome, the markers that your ancestors left you from thousands of years ago should still be in the same order. But there's a catch to the Y chromosome. It exists only in males, passed on directly from father to son. In fact, it's the Y chromosome that makes a male a male. There's another kind of DNA, though, located in a different part of the cell that's only passed on from mothers to their children. It's called mitochondrial DNA, or mtDNA for short. It's much smaller than the DNA that makes up our 23 pairs of chromosomes. But it contains the same kind of markers, the little genetic typos that pass unshuffled from generation to generation, on the maternal line. So by looking at markers on the Y chromosome and mitochondrial DNA, we can connect people alive today to ancestors that lived tens of thousands of years ago. Over the last several years, the Geographic Project has studied the Y chromosomes and mitochondrial DNA of more than 500,000 people. We now know that everyone on Earth belongs to one of hundreds of distinct groups of related people, based on which markers they have on their Y chromosome or mitochondrial DNA. We call these groups haplogroups. Each person in these groups traces their descent from a common ancestor. Haplogroups, your branch on the human family tree.